half of my time, only the last class to put it in the conference. And this work is from the University of Glasgow, and the title is Inductance-Based Self-Conflicted Using Various Composites. In this presentation, first I will talk about the device structure and the motivation for this work, and then I will talk about the details of the device fabrication and some material and mechanical characterization of the device. And finally, I will show some results about the response of the sensor to this actually, the motivation behind this work was to have a very flexible and soft sensor, a device that can act both as a sensor and can have the vibrational feedback, and to integrate this into the smart cards, mostly for the different communication. As the different people usually communicate through touch sensing, so they can touch the sensor and send the message, or they can receive message in the form of the vibration. But the part of the work that I'm presenting here today is mostly for the sensor part. This shows the simple structure of the device. It has a coil and a flexible substrate, polyamide. And through a magnetic elastomer made of an iron particle, it is a percentage of the iron particle. And then in the top, it is ecoflex, the iron particle is closer to each other and closer to the coil, and they can change the inductance of the coil. And the record is response by using the elastomer. And here, is, as I said, the device has two main parts. It is the coil and the ferromagnetic elastomer. Coil is made with the LIGA process, as I said, it's the simple and known technique. And it has mainly three steps, the lithography, molding, and electroplating. First, the thin layer of the coil and coil skin will be deposited on the polyamide with the even vibration technique, and then a thin layer of the photolysis was deposited on that, and then using the simple lithography technique, and the mask sample exposed to the UV light, and then they have a mold, and then they use the electroplating of the gold that you see this mold, and then finally they remove the, this thin layer of the gold and with the gold exchange. And the motivation for using this technique was to have enough thickness of the coil. Thickness was about 70 micrometers, and the thickness of the coil was 75 and the other part of the device was the elastomer, ferromagnetic elastomer, made with different percentages of coils and iron particles. They made this different ratio of the ecoflex and iron particle. The first one is ecoflex and the second iron particle. And the maximum percentage of the iron particle was 5 to 1, that 1 is ecoflex and 5 is iron particles. And then they put this composite in a mold, simple, and then just let it cure at room temperature for 4 hours. And because this process was not so much controlled, and then the iron particle is settled inside the composite, and then the first, the one part of the film had more density of the particle, and the other part has less. It means the particle was not distributed uniformly. And here shows the same image of the particle. It's not distributed uniformly. And the part with the more particle was called the dense side up. And it means, and when the dense side up was in contact with the coil, they call it DU, means dense side up. And then the other side with less particle was in contact, less particle was in contact with the coil, they call it dense side down. And they measure the performance of the sensor in the both cases. And before measuring the sensor response under the pressure, they measure the mechanical properties of the sensor. And the, obviously, they observe that the percentage of the iron particle is more the elastomer is more stiff and the linearity is increased. Also, Ethereum is here shows as the weight of the iron particle is more, the elastic modulus is more as we expected. But both of these results, they decided to consider 1 to 5 as the optimal percentage of the iron particle to elastomer. And the reason for that is essentially the it has a uniform change in the strength, in terms of the force in 1 to 5 percentage, which means it has the optimal thickness of the polymer. But in the other case, when the percentage of the ecoflex is more, in the first forces we had more changes, and then the change is decreased. Means the sensor couldn't have the uniform response in in the wide range of the force because it reached the saturation level. And here they measure the inductance, the constant force. This is the constant force. And generally, this one, when the gain side is down, the signal of the inductance signal is higher. Here it goes from 0 to 0.05, and it goes from 0 to 0.02. Means generally, the gain side of the polymer was up, the performance of the sensor was better. But at the moment, consider the 1 to 5 ratio of the ecoflex to iron particle as the optimal percentage. And as you see, the signal is not highest, but the reason is we see the linear response of the sensor. In 1 to 5, it has a wider linear range of the response, but in the other percentage, at the beginning, the sensor had a very good response, but then there is the saturation level, or in some cases, even the response decreased. So, based on that, they consider 1 to 5 as a. And then the gain side goes down as the optimal percentage of the ecoflex to the iron particles. And here they show the sensitivity. Generally, when the percentage of the iron particle was more, the sensitivity was higher. And again, they consider 1 to 5 as the best because if we see the response time of the sensor or the recovery time, in case of the 1 to 5, the response time was much faster, was 91 milliseconds, I think, and the recovery time also was very fast. And here is just an example of this sample under loading and unloading, includes 1 to 5 percentage, and comparing to the 5 to 1 is when the percentage of the ecoflex was much more. And then here you can see if the percentage of the ecoflex is more, the sensor has a negative response, even close to the ecoflex. So this was as a optimal percentage. The performance of the inductance-based substrate sensor is evaluated by using ferromagnetic elastomer, so it's the last ecoflex to iron particle. So generally, the sensor fabricated using the elastomer with higher iron particle gives the performance specificity of the iron particle. And the one-to-five shows the best performance is sensitivity of 0.053 over a pressure range of 2 to 14 kPa. And I choose that in the one price that they can find the system itself. And then after they apply the current to the coil, we can have a vibration in the next one.